Good morning. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today is election day, so make sure you go out and vote. It is a little before 7 a.m. and I'm at my shop. What's missing in this picture? Don't cheat, but what is missing in this picture? Don't cheat. Let me get your comment down in the comment section down below. If you didn't cheat, let me give you a hint. I'm gonna require this. Yes, I am an idiot. I let my truck run empty. And it's on the side of the road in front of the post office. Oh my God. So now I have to take this gas can, go to the gas station, put diesel in it, and head over to my truck and fill it up and get my day started. Oh, I am so dumb. When's the last time you ran out of gas?
Oh. I was like, what the fuck is going on?
The door is open.
I'm watching a little video this morning.
I'll give you a hint. The gas can on the floor is a hint.
Oh. All right, filled up that 5-gallon gas can. Got about 2/3 of it into the tank, which gave me a range of 25 miles. And now I'm at the gas station. That is absolutely ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Let's go, Brandon. Let's go, Brandon. It's been a long, long time since I maxed that out. A very long time. I'm gonna guess probably a good solid 4 or 5 years. That is just uneffing believable. Let's go, Brandon. All right, at my first service call of the day, it is 7:57. This job is scheduled for 8, and customer wants a new thermostat in the master bedroom suite. So I got my trusty White Rogers Series 80, the 1F83C, 11PR. It's great, great, reliable thermostat. Let's see if we get any good content here. All right, let's get going.
Good morning, man. Is he gonna bite me?
He's not a biter.
He's not a biter, he's a lover.
He's a barker.
Hi, Barker.
Chase, come here.
I'm here to replace the thermostat for you?
Right. Okay. The heat's not working, though.
Where?
I think in the whole house.
Oh, the heat's not working.
There's okay. No heat.
But maybe it's working. Let me go see that first.
Yeah.
You were about to say especially?
Especially in the bathroom, it was working, and then I what?
There's no heat up here either.
So it's the whole system.
Okay, let's go downstairs first.
Chase,
don't chase me. you're gonna chase me.
Thank you. I'll walk him off.
Hey, as long as you don't bite, I don't care.
He just got up. It's down there.
Thank you.
It's in that room in the back with the light.
Okay.
Oh no, it's in this side over here.
I'll follow the noise. Okay. I hear a noise. All right. All right. Screen of death. Screen of death. Let's see what's going on with this bad boy. Screen of death. Chase, you chasing me? Well, Ultra 230. Lockout info. Status lockout. High temp. High temperature lockout. Let's see why. Oh my God, my God, my God, my God. Keep watching. Trust me, you're not gonna wanna miss this one. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button, because there's a reason why the community gave me the name Saint Mike because we save people, their lives, their property as professionals on a daily basis. And what I'm staring at right now is absolutely mind-blowing and absolutely pathetic. And they are lucky to be alive. Let's forget about that for a minute. Seriously, let's take a step back. And don't worry, it's coming, guys. Keep watching. A.O. Smith, 75-gallon gas-fired water heater. I guess these guys on December 26th, 2019, replaced a thermocouple on this almost 10-year-old water heater. You have a recirculating pump there. Oh, don't worry, guys. It's coming. Do you feel it coming? Do you feel it coming? All right, let me show you. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Bingo. Let me look inside there. All right, we have a drip somewhere. This water just dropped on my head. Look at that. The reason why it's fogging up on the screen because exhaust gases are dumping right now onto the screen through the camera of the phone. Look at that. Wow. All right. Wow. Let's open some windows here, get some air. Let's set up the testo, see what's going on. I'm gonna turn this on outside. All right, as long as this thing is not producing carbon monoxide, they're alive. Drop of water there again. I got a leak. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I cannot make this stuff up. I just arrived here and 8:08, Tuesday, November 2nd. Look at this. Unfucking believable. Sorry for the curse word, but. Let's just test there, undiluted. See what's dumping out of this thing. Luckily, she's burning, you know, almost full, complete combustion, so just turn it off. All right, let's see what we're gonna do here. We are gonna have to, at a minimum, we gotta try to clean up the debris on this chimney. See what happens with that thing. Why she's going with the high temperature lockout. Let's look at all these zones here. You may recall this. Got some air in that zone. Master bath radiant. Nice job. Looks like got a radiant zone there as well. Master bath radiance. Where's the mixing valve for that bad boy? Not here. All right. Nice and pretty. All right. She's running. Let me try to clear off the screen. All right, let's address this disaster. Should I tell you or your husband what I see downstairs?
I'm afraid to hear it. What is it?
If all the exhaust gases from the water heater are dumping into the basement.
There's water in the basement?
No, the exhaust gases.
I don't know what that is.
You're lucky to be alive. Seriously.
Really?
Because the chimney has collapsed inside itself, and all of the exhaust gas, like the tailpipe of a car,
yeah,
is not going up the chimney, it's going into the basement.
Alright, you can tell him.
Alright, can I use the basement door instead of the...
Oh yeah, okay. Definitely.
Thank
you. Gotta open that little lock.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. Absolutely clueless. Wow. Alright. Use the basement entrance. Alright, fortunately, the husband realize the severity of what's going on. I told him that I have to make the situation safe and I'm not leaving until I do so. I told him I'm gonna do my best to vacuum out the chimney. He goes, oh, I called the chimney company, but he never showed up. I'm like, so you knew about this? And he's like, oh, it's not really a big deal. I was like, it is a big deal. It is. So I'm gonna vacuum out the chimney. I'm gonna put a reducer there and connect. If it needs 4 or 5 inch flue pipe going into the chimney, that's what I'm going to do. And someone's going to sign my invoice stating they have to get a chimney liner in there ASAP because it's going to happen again.
Completely caked and collapsed. I'm gonna try to vacuum that out, but I think they're gonna need a new chimney liner ASAP, like today. And I'm gonna put a piece of 4 inch there. That way I have the right pitch going in. And oh, I know why they did that, because this pipe was in the way. Unbelievable. First soot vac, but look at that, almost done. I just want to get the base a little bit more, and just got to change the bag. So in case you guys don't know what this is called a soot vac. A lot of boiler guys use this to vacuum out boilers, right? And what have you. I wasn't going to use this. I should have made this thing so full, but I didn't want to use my regular small Milwaukee M18 one, so I use this instead. This bag in there. Now that's out of the way. Let's get the new bag in place and finish vacuuming out the base of the chimney. I'm gonna take, that's it, you gotta put the bag in there. I'm gonna take rip that out. I'm just gonna take out that 9 inch and then connect with an elbow straight into the breaching, put a couple bricks there and some furnace cement, and call it a day. That just clips on
just like that. All right, just like that. Let's get back to work.
All right, I found a bunch of bricks in the backyard, threw some in there. Now I'm gonna take some furnace cement and seal that up. And then we'll do a combustion test, make sure we have great draft, and make sure everyone in this house is safe. All right, finished cleaning that up. Threw in a 4-inch adjustable smoke 90 there, a length of 4-inch single wall smoke pipe, another adjustable 4-inch 90, and another length of flue pipe going through the breaching of the foundation into the base of the chimney. And then I found some bricks around the backyard and then put furnace cement around there. Did a combustion test. Draft is great. We have great negative pressure and all of the exhaust gases are going up the chimney instead of into the house. Again, not a Picasso, but it is solid all the way around. And I feel confident now and can sleep well at night that I did this the right way.
All right, I hope you found this video educational and also hopefully somewhat entertaining. However, there is no entertainment in discovering that, you know, carbon monoxide is dumping into your customer's basement because the chimney has collapsed upon itself. Now, some of you may be thinking, Mikey Pipes, what happened to the tune-up? Well, since I keep it uncut, unedited, and raw, Mikey Pipes decided that we're going to reschedule a tune-up because the 2 hours that I had allocated for this customer for the tune-up was redirected into saving the occupants' lives who live in this home. Now, I know some of you are thinking, hogwash! The water heater was only producing 20 parts per million of carbon monoxide, so it wasn't a hazard. If you really do think that, I hope that you are not in the trades. I hope you are not a professional in the trades, because if you have that mentality, then you know what? Maybe you should be working at Burger King and McDonald's flipping burgers, because that is just total nonsense. We saved their lives by making the repair to that flue piping and to that chimney, and that's all I gotta say. So, it goes by saying, if you ain't testing, you're guessing. If you're not testing, you're guessing. And if you would like a sticker, email me, mike@mikeypipes.com. And all the trolls, go play in traffic. Like, serious, go play on Sunrise Highway at the corner of Sunrise Highway and Peninsula Boulevard in Lynbrook. That's a great, great intersection for the trolls to be playing in. You know, go play, go kick a ball back and forth, right? Some people, I swear. Anyway, make sure you check us out on Discord and on WhatsApp, because we're very active there on both. Discord, WhatsApp, links in the description box down below.